All right, Kelli, listen, I need you to take over my tutoring session for today. How are your grades?
Oh, great, yeah.
Great. See, I'm behind in my work, and if you do well today, you can have the job for good, all right?
Thank you.
All the money that goes along with it. Okay? Okay.
All right, thanks.
All right.
Hello, I'm Kelli, and I'm going to be your tutor. Jesse's not here because he's a little overwhelmed, if you know what I mean. So, I'm going to put on my glasses, and I'm going to be your tutor. So, if you have a question, just raise your hand. I'll walk over to your desk. You'll give me the question. I'll analyze it in my brain, and then I'll give you the correct answer. So, any questions?
I have a question.
Oh, well, let's see what you got.
I have a philosophy question. Are you familiar with philosophy?
Yeah, sure. Philosophy, whatever.
Okay. Well, could you explain the allegory of the cave to me? I can't get it. I don't understand.
Oh, yes. The cave. Of course I can explain that. Perhaps the first question we must ask is, what kind of man is in the cave? Maybe he is the unenlightened layman. Maybe. He's an expert in martial arts and manages a billion-dollar company. Maybe he has a secret, a past filled with sadness and pain. Maybe he is Bruce Wayne, Batman, if you will. And the real conundrum is whether you should fight crime with altruistic motives or for revenge. That is the allegory of the Batcave.
Are you talking about Plato?
No, I haven't played with that stuff in years. Of course not.
I have a question now.
Yes, what is it about?
Actually, it's an accounting question. This is my first principal's class, and while everybody seems to be catching on to book value, I'm still struggling with it. I was just wondering if you could help me out.
Oh yes, book value, of course. Yes, of course I can answer this. Easy, easy. Check this out. Book value. So, that's about all you need to know.
That doesn't make sense at all.
Can you answer my question now?
Oh, most definitely. What is it?
Okay, I'm having trouble finding the GCD of these two numbers using the Euclidean algorithm.
A math question. Oh gosh, I didn't think anybody was going to ask one of these. It's not really my best subject.
Where are you going?
I punched her!
You're fired!
Math!
Just put on this shirt and make coffee.
Yes, sir. Well, that sounds easy.
It is easy.
That was easy. That was easy. That was easy.
Hey, Kelli. Just so you know, you can have all the free coffee that you want.
Really?
Yeah.
Something ain't right. My best friend told me what to do to you last night. Let me see it in my bed.
way. Make the sunshine brighter than the darkest day. Turn the bright spark into a flame.
The bike? You are fired.
Coffee! I know your line of work has really strict standards. And I know I don't look like much, but I've got what it takes.
Well, do you at least have a resume?
Sure.
Okay, I'll give you a shot.
Oh, thank you. Oh, thanks.
Okay, get to work. Oh, wait, forgot your flashlight. And don't run like that.
Oh, hey, could you escort me and my boyfriend across campus?
Why can't he do it?
Well, you see, last time he did it, we got mugged. And I'd rather a real man walked us across campus.
Okay.
Whoa. We're okay, let's keep going.
Hey! Give me your money! Seriously, give me your money now. I still want your money. Here we go, come on. Thank you.
Whoa, what's going on?
I'm so sorry. I was escorting some people, and then this guy came up, and they mugged them, and I ran, and I think I ran into a tree, and I think I fell.
Are you gonna fire me?
You know, normally, we'd fire somebody for something like that. But you know, I have a feeling about you, kid. I'm gonna give you a second chance.
Thanks! What should I do?
You know what to do. All right.
Hey,